The construction of the U.S. Navy's next class of guided missile frigates officially began on August 31st, with the first steel for the ship cut in a small ceremony at the Fincantieri Marinette Marine Shipyard in Marinette, Wisconsin. The future USS Constellation, FFG 62, will be the lead ship of a class of at least 20 frigates and is slated for delivery in 2026. The hull of the frigate is based on the Italian FREMM-class frigate and will be equipped with proven weapons and combat systems. Three Constellation-class FFGs, Constellation FFG 62, Congress FFG 63, and Chesapeake FFG 64 currently are on order. In June, the Navy exercised a contract option to order FFG 64. Marinette Marine is now under contract for those first three FFGs, with options for seven more. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how capable is the new Constellation-class frigate of the U.S. Navy. Let's get into the details. This video is sponsored by War Thunder, the most comprehensive military vehicle online game for PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One, in which you can go to battle on more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s. The game has an amazing attention to detail and focuses on a realistic combat experience, which is why knowing your vehicles and skill really makes a difference. It's easy to get into, and all you need to play is nothing more but your mouse and keyboard or controller. Immerse yourself in cross-platform combat with more than 20 million other military vehicle enthusiasts from all over the world. Download and play War Thunder for free using the link in the description below, and also get a free bonus tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account. The Constellation class is a class of multi-mission guided missile frigates under development for the United States Navy in a follow-on to the modular, littoral combat ship. The U.S. Navy announced the FFGX frigate project in the United States Department of Defense Request for Information (RFI) on the 10th of July 2017. The U.S. Navy selected five shipbuilders to evolve their designs into a prospective design for the proposed 20 FFGX guided missile frigates. On the 30th of April 2020, it was announced that Fincantieri Marinette Marine had won the contract with its FREMM multi-purpose frigate-based design. The project was later renamed the FFG-62 program after the lead ship was named. The U.S. Navy expects the warships of this class to be able to perform the following. 1. Destroy surface ships over the horizon. 2. Detect enemy submarines. 3. Defend convoy ships. 4. Employ active and passive electronic warfare systems. 5. Defend against swarming small boat attacks. Constellation-class frigates are a key component of the recently released Chief of Naval Operations Navigation Plan, NAV Plan 2022, which envisions a future hybrid fleet composed of 350 manned ships and approximately 150 unmanned ships. Although based on the FREMM frigate, the Constellation will have a longer hull and features modified to meet U.S. Navy standards on reliability, survivability, maintainability, habitability, and lethality. The 49-foot-long steel ship will displace 7,300 tons and have a beam of 64.6 feet and draft of 18 feet. It will be powered by a combination diesel-electric and gas turbine propulsion system. The FFG will feature a minimum of 32 Mark 41 vertical launching system, canister-launched naval strike missiles, Mark 110 57mm gun, RAM Mark 49 launcher, CAPTIS 4 variable depth sonar, TB-37 multifunction towed array, SQQ-89 V-16 undersea combat system, SLQ-25E Nixie, SLQ-32V6 SEWIP Block 2, SPY-6V3 FFG Radar, Aegis Baseline 10 Combat System, 1 MH-60R Helicopter, 1 MQ-8C Unmanned Aerial Vehicle, and 2 7-meter Rigid Hull Inflatable Boats. The offensive punch will mainly come from the 32 Mark 41 Vertical Launching System and Naval Strike Missiles. Mark 41 VLS can be equipped with weapons like BGM-109 Tomahawk Cruise Missile for land attack, RIM-66 Standard Missile 2 SM-2 Surface-to-Air Missile for air defense, RIM-161 Standard Missile 3 SM-3 for Aegis Ballistic Missile Defense, RUM-132 VL ASROC Missile for anti-submarine role, RIM-174 Standard Extended Range Active Missile ERAM, or Standard Missile 6 SM-6 for anti-air warfare, as well as anti-ship and RIM-162 Evolved Sea Sparrow Missiles ESSM, which can be quad-packed and is designed to protect ships from attacking missiles and aircraft. The NSM is the upgrade of Kongsberg's Penguin short-to-medium-range anti-ship guided missile. The state-of-the-art design and use of composite materials are meant to give the missile sophisticated stealth capabilities. The missile will weigh slightly more than 400 kilograms or 880 pounds and have a range of more than 185 kilometers or 100 nautical miles. NSM is designed for littoral waters, brown water, as well as for open sea, green and blue water scenarios. NSM is able to fly over and around landmasses, travel in sea skim mode, and then make random maneuvers in the terminal phase, making it harder to stop by enemy countermeasures. According to the NAV plan, the Constellation-class frigate will be capable of defending the fleet, striking adversary forces in all domains, and expanding interoperability with allies and partners. The new frigates are designed to operate in both open ocean and littoral environments as part of a carrier or expeditionary strike group or a surface action group. Since the ships are being equipped with proven techniques and systems already in use today, the timeline to get this new capability to the fleet is shrunk. U.S. Navy has been focusing to make the fleet more networked and distributed in view of the emerging threats. The distributed lethality concept aims to disperse firepower across different platforms, and Constellation-class frigate fits into this perfectly. The class will go a long way in enhancing the U.S. Navy's warfighting abilities.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.